Okay, next we are going to see hyperbolic functions. Sin hz is equal to e power z minus of e power minus z by 2. Cos hz is equal to e power z plus e power minus z by 2. And cos square z minus sin square z is equal to 1. And secant square hz plus tan square z is equal to 1. And cot square hz is equal to 1 plus cosecant square hz. Now we'll try to find out the real part of cos hz and the imaginary part of cos hz and the mod cos hz by using this hyperbolic functions. Now how to do the first one? Now what is cos hz? Cos hz is, this is what? 1 by 2 e power z plus e power minus z. Okay, so that is equal to 1 by 2. E power z means e power x plus iy plus e power minus of x plus iy. Okay, this is 1 by 2 e power x into e power plus iy plus e power minus x into minus iy. Okay, now this is 1 by 2 e power x into this is cos y plus I sin y, the formula of e power iy means e power theta, plus e power minus x into cos y, this is minus y, no? So minus cos minus y is again cos y, minus I sin y. I may write this as cos y minus I sin y, right? Clear? Okay, because my sin minus theta is minus sin theta. Okay, so if I multiply, this is e power x cos y plus I into e power x sin y plus e power minus x cos y and minus I into e power minus x sin y cos x. Okay, like this if I multiply. Or you can take common such that we'll be having the value in the form of like this. Now 1 by 2, what we'll do is we'll be taking common e power x. This is e power x cos y plus I sin y. Okay, I'm just taking the common here, e power x plus cos y. Okay, cos y, if you take cos y common, e power x plus e power minus x cos y, that will be better. E power x cos y plus I into e power x minus of e power x. This is e power x minus e power minus x, you'll be getting as sin y. This is not cos x, this is sin y. You'll be getting as sin y. Okay, now this is e power minus x by 2 cos y plus I into e power x minus of e power x by 2 sin y. Okay, now this is e power x plus e power minus x is nothing but this is the form of what? Cos hz. Okay, cos hx. I am writing this as cos hx cos y plus. If you take minus common here, you'll be getting as I into. You may write as this as total. You can write I into sine h here in the place of a z is x sine y. So cos hx cos y plus I sine hx sine y. This is sine hx, I into sine hx. Now what you got here is, you got as total, you got as cos hz, you got as cos hx cos y plus I sin hx sin y. Now this you got total. So that is nothing but u plus iv. Okay, this is, you may take it as u plus iv. Real part is nothing but real part of cos hz is nothing but cos hx cos y, imaginary part of cos hz is sin hx again sin y. Now this is what they wanted to know, right? Next, cos hz holds mod square. I'll take this one. So this will be cos hx square cos square y plus sin square hx sin square y. This is mod z square form. Okay, this cos square hx can be changed as some 1 plus sin h square x cos square y, because cos square x minus sin square, cos h square x minus sin h square is equal to 1. So therefore this is what, plus again if this is sin h square x is equal to 1 minus cos square y. Yes, this is x only, right? This is cos square y, this is sin h square x cos square y plus sin h square x cos square y. I'm just multiplying inside. This is sin h square x cos square y, multiplying inside you'll be getting this. Now this one and this one will get cancelled, you'll be getting as cos square y plus sin h square x. Now this is the value of this one. Again, if you can change this one, you can change in another pattern also, like by changing the cos square y as 1 minus sin square y, and you may change this also like cos h square x minus 1, such that you will be getting as these two cancel, you get cos h square x minus sin square y. Like this also you can change, or you can put in the form of like this. This is how you can change the problem. Now we'll try to prove one important problem which gives 12 marks in the examination. That we'll try to find out. Find all the roots of the equation. We'll do one problem. Sin hz is equal to I. This one, there are many problems are there. The BBT is there. That is cos hz is equal to 1 by 2. CBT is also there. Cos hz is minus 2. Okay. So first we'll do sin hz is equal to I. The first one. Sin hz is equal to I. So therefore the solution. So we know that sin hz, how we find cos hz, we have sin hz also. Sin hz is nothing but sin hx cos y, sin hx cos y plus I cos hx sin y. This is what the value which we got after finding that by taking x plus iy, and if you multiply inside you'll be getting the value like this. Okay, so therefore sin hz is equal to I, that implies sin hx cos y plus I cos hx sin y is equal to I. So equating real and imaginary parts, so that implies you'll be getting as sin hx cos y is equal to 0, anyhow this is real part, and cos hx sin y is equal to I. You got as two values. Now from this we are going to find out the value. Two cases will be arising. So from sin hx cos y is equal to 0, then we get two cases. So case 1 is sin hx equal to 0. Case 2 is cos y equal to 0. There are two cases will arise. One is hx equal to 0. The other one is cos y equal to 0. Now case 1. First one we will try to prove. The first one. sin hx equal to 0. So x is 0. When sin 0, it will be 0. So I am taking directly x is equal to 0. So if you take x equal to 0 in this you will be getting as substituting in this, that is cos hx sin y is equal to I. So x equal to 0, if you put 0 here, this is 0 means 1 into sin y is equal to I. You got as 1 into sin y is equal to I. Okay, now here not 1, this is nothing but I, this is not this is I. So if we equate to imaginary, this becomes as 1. So therefore this is nothing but 1. So sin y is equal to 1. So therefore when sin y is equal to 1, y is equal to 4n plus 1 pi by 2, where n belongs to integers. So when this value sin 4n plus 1 pi by 2, you will be getting as 1. So y you got, x you got. So in this case z is equal to x plus I y. So x is nothing but 0 plus I into 4n plus 1 pi by 2. So therefore z is equal to I into 4n plus 1 pi by 2, where n belongs to the integers. Now this is, in this case we got the z value as in the form of like that. Now we'll try to prove the value for second case. Second case is cos y equal to 0. Now how you will get cos y equal to 0, that we'll see. Cos y equal to 0. So case 2. Cos y equal to 0. So that implies, so when cos will be 0, y is equal to 2n plus 1 pi by 2, where n belongs to z, it will be 0. So y is nothing but this. Now we'll try to substitute this one here. So now cos hx sin y is equal to 1. What is cos h? That is nothing but sin y. Cos hx sin 2n plus 1 pi by 2 is equal to 1. So sin 2n plus 1 pi by 2 is nothing but, it is minus 1. So I'll write as, you may get minus 1 whole power n here. N may be, if you take even, it will be 1. If you take odd, it will be minus 1. So therefore what you are going to have is, so cos hx is equal to 1 if n is nothing but equal to even, 2n. So hx, when cos will be 1, so therefore this implies x equal to 0. If you put x equal to 0, then cos will be 1. So what you got here, from here, x you know, y you know. So in this case, z is equal to x plus I y, x is 0 plus I into y is nothing but 2n plus 1 pi by 2. But here n is what? 2n. So I may write as z is equal to I into, in the place of n, 2m. So this is 4m plus 1 pi by 2, where n is nothing but equal to 2m, where m belongs to the integers. Now this is the case 2. So like this you will be getting as 2 cases for every problem, so that you will get the answer. Okay, this is how you can do the problems of finding the roots. Now we'll do one more important problem, that is cos hz is equal to 2. This is very very important, it gives for the 12 marks. Okay, cos hz equal to 2. Okay, now we'll try to write this one. Cos hz is nothing but, we are just now we found, that is cos hx cos y plus sin hx sin y. Now this is what we have, so therefore cos hz is equal to 2, that implies cos hx cos y plus I into sin hx sin y is equal to 2. So equating imaginary and real parts, cos hx cos y is equal to 0, is equal to 2, and sin hx sin y is equal to 0. Again we arises two cases. So from sin hx, sin y equal to 0, we will get two cases. That is case 1, two cases. One is sin hx equal to 0, and the second one is sin y equal to 0. Again we got a two cases. Now case 1, sin hx equal to 0. The first case is sin hx equal to 0. This already you know, x equal to 0. When you put x equal to 0, sin hx is nothing but 0. So we'll put x equal to 0 here. That is cos hx, cos y is equal to 2. Now put x equal to 0, you'll be getting as 1. Cos y is equal to 2. So therefore this implies cos y is equal to 2. Okay. Now which has no solutions? Which has no solution, because cos hx is less than or equal to 1. But here it is 2. So there will be no solution for this. There is no solution for this. Okay. Now we'll go for the other case. In this case, there is no solution. Now we'll take sin y equal to 0. The other condition. The case 2 condition is sin y. Sin y equal to 0. So when the sin will be 0, then sin will be, I may take sin y is nothing but equal to n pi. When it is n pi, it is 0. So if you put 0 here, if you put y equal to 0, this is 0, again cos hx is nothing but 2 you will get. Again it's a problem. So that's why, because of that, I'm taking sin y equal to n pi. You should understand, if I write y equal to 0, sin 0 is 0. That is also correct. But if you write y equal to 0 here, if I write y equal to 0, again you will be getting as cos hx equal to 2. Again it's a problem. So I am taking y is equal to n pi. So therefore n pi, for all n belongs to z. That is nothing but integers. Okay. Now what is that now? Now we'll substitute this one in this. Cos hx, cos n pi is equal to 2. Cos hx, this is minus 1 whole power n is equal to 2. Again, this is minus 1 whole power n equal to 2. Then this is cos hx is equal to 2, for all n is equal to 2m, where n belongs to integers, for all integers. Now what I got, cos hx is equal to, I should find the value of x. So this I'll write in the formula e power x plus e power minus x by 2 is equal to 2. Now I'll simplify this by taking e power x, this one. Okay. This is e power x, e power minus x is equal to 4. This is e power x plus 1 by e power x is equal to 4. This is e power x square plus 1 is equal to 4 into e power x. Let e power x is equal to t. Now this is t square plus 1 is equal to 4t. This is t square minus 4t plus 1 equal to 0. What we have done in the previous problem for cos z is equal to same thing. Now what you got is cos, we got as t square minus 4t plus 1 equal to 0. Okay, t is equal to minus b. So 4 plus r minus root of b square, 16 minus 2ac. B square minus 4ac, sorry. So b square minus 4ac is nothing but 4 by 2. 2a is nothing but that is. This is 4 plus r minus. This is 12 by 2. This is nothing but 2 plus r minus root 3. The t is equal to 2 plus r minus root 3. So you got as 2 plus r minus root 3. So what is t actually? T is nothing but what? T is nothing but e power x. So e power x is equal to 2 plus r minus root 3. X equal to log 2 plus r minus root 3. Now x equal to this you got. And the y is equal to n pi. You got as y is equal to n pi. So therefore what you can write here is, therefore you may have y equal to n pi. So therefore z is equal to x plus iy. X is nothing but log 2 plus r minus root 3 plus I into n pi. Means I may write here is 2m pi. 2m pi is the answer. Okay. So x is nothing but that. Okay. Right. Plus or minus 2n pi. Okay. Yes. 2m pi. So therefore this may be equal to, z is equal to plus or minus log 2 plus root 3 plus I into 2m pi. I into 2m pi. Okay. Now how you got this one? We'll try to check it. Okay. This is plus or minus. No. So what I'll do is, I'll just explain how you got this. This is 2 plus root 3 is equal to. If I wanted to rationalize this, 2 plus root 3, 2 minus root 3, 2 minus root 3. So you'll be getting as 1 by 2 minus root 3. This is 2 minus root 3 whole power minus 1. If you take log, log 2 plus root 3 may be equal to minus log 2 minus root 3. Or you can write minus here. Similarly, 2 minus root 3. So 2 plus root 2 minus root 3. 2 plus root 3 by 2 plus root 3. So again you will be getting 1 by 2 plus root 3. Again if you take log, log of 2 minus root 3, you will be getting as minus log 2 plus root 3. Because this will go up, no? 2 plus root 3 to the power of minus 1. So again you may have minus here. So if you may get log 2 minus root 3 and you may got log 2 minus root 3. This is plus. And both, if it is plus or minus, you got the same value. This value is also like this, and you can say, I can write this also like this. Log 2 plus root 3 isolate. So minus value and the plus value, both the values are nothing but the similar. I may write this minus over here. I may write this minus over here, such that the both values are nothing but minus. So therefore, plus or minus log 2 plus root 3 will be the same. So therefore, I plus I into 2m plus 5, where m belongs to the integers. So this is how you can do the hyperbolic functions in the same manner. Okay, thank you.